1 second. We think they've got one more stop. Time last lap was a 1 minute 45.9. We're gaining by around 0.2 per lap. Keep going. Okay, safety car deployed. Safety car's been deployed. Watch your delta. Make sure you keep it positive as we catch the pack. Alexander's coming in for his stop now. Right, drop your speed. Our delta's too low and we're going to risk a... penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Alright, we're last of the running cars right now. Stroll is ahead of you. They're on fresh mediums. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. 21 laps to go.
Thank you.
Okay, Magnussen in the pits. Okay, Sainz is behind you. They're on fresh softs. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature, and remember, there's no overtaking until the timing line. Stay in position until the green flags. Okay, clear. Overtake and burn off some of this energy. Right, we need to get past here. Use overtake. 31 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Okay, Tsunoda's behind you. The distance to the leader is 5.0 seconds. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Old. Your last lap time was a 1:47.3. Okay, so you're gaining by 1/10 a lap. Okay, keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 1.5 seconds. Leclerc is ahead of you. Okay, so the gap to the car ahead. ahead, 1.5 seconds. Okay, they're on fresh hards. Ocon behind. Okay, the gap is less than a second. Okay, they're on old softs. Okay, so gap to the leader is 9.5 seconds. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Gap to your teammate behind is 1.8 seconds. Box issue, but I'm afraid there's nothing we can do. Try and drive around it, we'll just have to hope for the best. Remember, you've got a lot of torque in these power units, so you should be able to stay in high gears for a lot of the lap. First place is 11.1 seconds. Look after these tyres now, we want to finish the race on this compound. Manage your tyres. Pushing. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 2.3 seconds. They're on old mediums. They're in 10th place. Time last lap was a 1:46.9. Their tyres are 12 laps old. Your last lap time was a 1 minute 46.7. Okay, so you're gaining by 1/10 a lap. Okay, gap ahead is 2.6 seconds. Thank you. safe place. Piastri's ahead of you. Okay, keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 1.8 seconds. Okay, they're on old hard tyres. Ocon behind. Okay, gap to the car behind. Car behind. 1.4 seconds. Okay, they're on old softs. Okay, gap to leader. 18.8 seconds. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. By 5/10 a lap. P7 now, P7, Piastri ahead. Okay, the gap is less than a second. Okay, they're on old hard tyres. Ocon behind. And the gap behind us is 1.9 seconds. Okay, they're on old softs. The distance to the leader is 17.9 seconds. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Come on, just three laps to go. Three laps. Some of this energy, come on. Race over, take care of the car on the way in.
Here we are then, it's victory in Azerbaijan. Great work from the whole team here at the track and back at the factory as well. And some pretty handy driving for good measure. Anthony Davidson, someone help them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
Our winning drivers are on their way to the podium right now. It's been a fantastic race for McLaren, that's for sure. And no doubt, they'll be celebrating tonight. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Our championship leader is still sat at the top of the standings, but their rivals have made up some solid ground today. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
I think for Driver of the Day, I'd probably pick Lando Norris. He lived up to every inch of his reputation today, and I think he'll be going home, quite rightly, a bit proud of himself.
It's time to check out the Constructors' Standings. Ferrari continue to extend the gap at the top of the table. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. After an event like that, who knows?